brothers and sisters, to increase your iman. Read the miracle, recite the Qur'an. Recite it every day and do read it loud. The verses of Qur'an are all Muslims' pride. This miracle was revealed over a long time span, sent from Allah to an angel then to a man. That man was Muhammad, the best of creation.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Alhamdulillahi wa kafa wa salamun ala ibadihi alladhina istafa. لا سيما المصطفى صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. Dear brothers and sisters everywhere, welcome to a new episode of your program, Correct Your Recitation. After welcoming all of you and our studio guests, Assalamu alaikum, and thank you for joining us. As usual, we'll begin by reciting the ayat, the Quranic verses, which we intend to explain their meaning and also practice in the next segment, inshallah, the rules of tajweed. Unfortunately, we're missing Sheikh Abdul Khaliq as well, because now the Isha prayer coincides with the time of the program, so he has to lead the Isha prayer, and it's like I'm stuck here and I have to play that role, so bear with me, inshallah. Inshallah, we'll recite from ayah number 75 of Surah Al-Waqi'aah to the end of the same surah. A'udhu billahi min ash-shaytanir rajim. فلا أقسم بمواقع النجوم وإنه لقسم لو تعلمون عظيم إنه لقرآن كريم في كتاب مكنون لا يمسه إلا المطهرون تنزيل من رب العالمين أفبهذا الحديث أنتم مدهنون وتجعلون رزقكم أنكم تكذبون فلولا إذا بلغت الحلقوم وأنتم حينئذ تنظرون ونحن أقرب إليه منكم ولكن لا تبصرون فلولا إن كنتم غير مدينين ترجعونها إن كنتم صادقين فأما فروح وريحان وجنة نعيم وأما إن كان من أصحاب فسلام لك من أصحاب اليمين وأما إن كان من المكذبين الضالين فنزل من وتصلية جحيم إن هذا لهو حق اليقين
فسبح باسم ربك العظيم.
سبحان ربي العظيم. The last ayah of Surat Al-Waqi'aah, فسبح باسم ربك العظيم, which is a divine command from Allah the Almighty to the reciters, to the readers, and to the believers to glorify the name of Allah the Most High and the Greatest. فسبح باسم ربك العظيم. And it was also revealed in ayah number 47, the ayah which concluded the indications of the Lordship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when he presented the questions of أَفَرَأَيْتُمْ مَا تُمْنُونَ أَفَرَأَيْتُمْ مَا تَحْرُثُونَ in 63, then أَفَرَأَيْتُمْ مَا الَّذِي تَشْرَبُونَ in 68, then أَفَرَأَيْتُمُ النَّارَ الَّتِي تُورُونَ in ayah number 71. The conclusion was فَسَبِّحْ بِاسْمِ رَبِّكَ الْعَظِيمِ, glorify the name of your Lord, the Great. When this ayah was revealed, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, اجعلوها في ركوعكم. Make the application of this command in your ruku', when you're bound down in the prayer. And this is how it was prescribed in ruku', while bound down, to say, سبحان ربي العظيم, سبحان ربي العظيم, سبحان ربي العظيم, glory be to my Lord, the Great. So, at-tasbih is to sit free from any imperfection. And the only one who is entirely free from any deficiency and imperfection is definitely the Creator, Allah the Almighty alone. In ayah number 11 of Surah Ash-Shura, Allah the Almighty says, لَيْسَ كَمِثْلِهِ شَيْءٌ وَهُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْبَصِيرُ. There is nothing like him, and he is the all-hearer, the all-seer. And he said in the fourth ayah of Surah Al-Ikhlas, وَلَمْ يَكُلْ لَهُ كُفُوًا أَحَدٌ. And there is no one equivalent nor comparable to him. He is the most perfect, he is the greatest, he is the most high, he is the omnipotent, Allah the Almighty. So, فَلَا أُقُسِمُ بِمَوَاقِعِ النُّجُومِ. These ayat by the end are very, very important. And in order to comprehend the meaning of this ayah, there are a few vocabulary that I would like to share with you the meanings. The word an-nujum means the stars. Mawaqi' means sitting or the sites, plural of mawqi'. Mawqi' is a site. Mawaqi' sites. Bimawaqi' is a preposition. The ba is a preposition which means I swear by or I swear two, because it's preceded by the word أقسم, I swear. So بمواقع النجوم, by the setting of the stars. We'll take it as is for now, because when we come to give the tafsir, we will refer to the different meanings according to the different interpretation of مواقع النجوم in this ayah, which is ayah number 75 of Surah Al-Waqi'ah. The word maknoon means well preserved, well guarded. And mudhinoon means discourse and are indifferent. The word madineen, in order to understand the word madineen, remember that in Surah Al-Fatiha we recite Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, Maliki Yawm Ad-Din. Ad-Din is the reckoning. Maliki Yawm Ad-Din, he is the owner and the king of the day of reckoning. So Ad-Din, Madineen, means that you will not be reckoned. You will not be held accountable. What does it mean exactly? غَيْرَ مَدِينِين, not to be reckoned or accounted. The word فَرَوْحٌ. الروح here is different than الروح. الروح means a state of rest, comfort, and relief. الريحان, it refers to the delight and the infinite joy. The word تَصْلِيَة, The word tasliyah means burning. Jahim is the blazing fire. May Allah the Almighty protect us against it. In ayah number 75, Allah the Almighty began by an oath. And we mentioned repeatedly, whenever Allah swears, He may swear with whatever He desires of His creation. And whenever He utilizes any of the creatures as a subject or as a mean of oath, it refers to two things. Number one, the greatness of the subject. لا أقسم بيوم القيامة. The day of judgment is such a great day. And whenever He swears by something He also, which is great, it refers to the greatness of the Creator Himself. But we do have a linguistic issue here which many people may not comprehend, unless if you master the Arabic language, which is La. La means Nahi, no, negation, nullification. So do you want to swear or you don't want to swear? What do you mean when you say La uqusimu? If you say La uqusimu out of context, it means I do not swear. I'm not going to swear. لا أقسم. I do not swear. But here, فلا أقسم بمواقع النجوم. The interpreters of the Quran refer to a very significant meaning of bringing the word nay or nay or la. The negation in the beginning. They say it's an alert. It's an alarm sign. Wait a minute, listen carefully. The upcoming event is such a great thing, that's why Allah is going to swear. He doesn't have to. But when He swears, that means something really serious. You got to pay close attention to it. It's like ringing the bell. Nay. Other interpreters of the Quran, they said, there is another very hidden significant meaning, which is, every time there is La uqusimu. La uqusimu. La does not negate al-qasam, the oath. Rather, it's where the subject of the oath, which the non-believers deny. When Allah says, لا أقسم بهذا البلد, لا أقسم بيوم القيامة, لا أقسم بالنفس اللوامة. Let's take one example. لا أقسم بيوم القيامة. Nay, I swear to the day of resurrection. It's like that. Where many people deny accountability, resurrection, and life after death, it began by, nay, what you guys deny is actually the ultimate truth. So your denial is dismissed. أقسم, I swear, that is the thing. It is like that. So la jumps to dismiss and nullify what they deny. Their denial is dismissed. So this is one opinion, and it's very respected. I like it a lot. Also, using the word La as an alarm and ringing the bell makes a great sense. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says here, فَلَا أُقُسِمُ بِمَوَاقِعِ النُّجُومِ. We said the word مَوَاقِع means the setting or the sights. And nujum means the stars. What does it mean? Either it means, I swear to the setting of the stars and their sights, which happens every day. When does the sun set? At sun setting. When the sun sets indicates the beginning of the night. And when the sun rises, it indicates the beginning of the day. The opposite is true with the stars. When the star sets, it's an indication of the approaching of the day. And when the stars appear in the sky, it's an indication of... Okay? So when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, بِمَوَاقِعِ النُّجُومِ, with the setting, sights of the stars. So what? What does it mean? Before I say the subject of the oath, look at the following ayah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَإِنَّهُ لَقَسَمٌ لَوْ تَعْلَمُونَ عَظِيمٌ. This is indeed a great oath. What Allah is swearing to is something very great, if you really know. So He's bringing to our attention the importance of reflecting on the setting of the stars. If the setting of the stars indicates the departure of the night and the beginning or the approach of the day and the setting of the sun indicates the opposite. Well, we studied in Surah Al-Imran that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in certain ayat from 190, where Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam cried when these ayat were revealed in his night prayer, and he wet his beard, he wet his clothes, he wet the floor beneath him. And he said, woe to him who would not reflect upon these ayat. And furthermore, every night when he got up to pray tahajjud, he would recite these ayat from 190 to the end of Surah Al-Imran. إِنَّ فِي خَلْقِ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَاخْتِلَافِ اللَّيْلِ وَالنَّهَارِ لَآيَاتٍ لِأُولِي الْأَلْبَابِ. Indeed, in the creation of the heavens and the earth, اختلاف الليل والنهار, the alternation of the day, of the night, and the day and the night, and following each other with succession. In that, there are signs. For whom? For men of understanding. We should not just let go a day after day and a night after night without reflecting upon that. You know, Al-Hasan al-Basri, may Allah have mercy on him, says, you're not but some days. Whenever a day goes by, you're running in minus. You're running short of days. إِنَّمَا أَنْتَ أَيَّام. You are a bunch of days. Whenever a day departs, a part of you is gone. And what is left is keeping getting lesser and lesser. So think about time. Think about the solar system. Think about the moon following the sun setting. And when the moon departs and the sun rises. And similarly, when the stars set and the sun rises. On each day that is happening on a regular basis, Allah is ordering us to reflect upon that. وَإِنَّهُ لَقَسَمٌ لَوْ تَعْلَمُونَ عَظِيمٌ. Indeed, this is a great oath, if you but to know. So what does it mean? It means pay attention to this and think about it. There is another reason why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala swears to the stars and their sitting sites or places. As I say, there are two interpretations of the word بِمَوَاقِعِ النُّجُومِ. One, which is referring to the sitting sites of the stars. Because the Meccan pagans, and people even from the time of Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam, they believed in the stars. And they believed in the mystic power that it can create, it can harm, it can benefit. And they decided their trips based on that. Not only that. Whenever a rain would fall, they would say, مُطُرْنَا بِنُوءِ كَذَا وَكَذَا. Because of such and such star, we receive the rain. Once the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, after finishing the Fajr prayer or the Subh prayer, in the side place of Sulh al-Hudaybiyah, al-Hudaybiyah, if you remember, on the sixth year after the migration during the Treaty of al-Hudaybiyah, he finished the prayer, then he turned to his companions and said, that every morning Allah the Almighty says that أَصْبَحَ مُؤْمِنٌ بِي وَكَافِرٌ بِي. This morning some of my servants have woken up in the morning as believers and some woke up in the morning as non-believers. As far as for the believers, they said مُطَرْنَا بِفَضْلِ اللَّهِ وَرَحْمَتِهِ. We receive the rain by Allah's grace and mercy. And others would say, مُطِرْنَا, we receive the rain because of the favor of such and such star. Who brings the stars up and who causes them to set? Allah, the Almighty, is their creator. You know, since we were young and in schools, there are some statements teachers would teach the students without reflecting upon their meanings. Those faces are words of disbelief. For instance, when they say, as they taught us in Arabic, that Egypt as a country is the gift of the River Nile. Without the River Nile, Egypt would not have existed. The River Nile granted Egypt life. No, it is Allah who granted the River Nile life and made the water run through it. And it is Allah subhanahu run through it what? From bottom to top. This is very amazing. From bottom to top, from south to north. And it is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who granted life not just to Egypt but to everything that exists. And he is the only one who gives life and death. So these statements, we have to be very careful. Like the pagans, like the non-believers say, Mutirna, because of such and such. We receive the rain because of such and such. I was sitting with a woman whom I was giving her da'wah to accept Islam. And by the grace of Allah, she did accept Islam. Then we, alhamdulillah, shukrillah, she's a British woman. And one of the things that she made mention of is touch wood. You know, normally people say touch wood in what context? For what reason? What is the significance of this? Like, you know, to divert the evil eye and to protect yourself against envy. With the wood, and why wood? Not glass, not metal, not plastic. Why wood? There is a reason behind it, because it's referring to the wood of the cross. So many Muslims say touch wood, even in Arabic, without knowing the meaning of that. So you got to understand that everything is created by Allah, and it is not permissible to take any means of approach of the creation to reach to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or believe that anything other than Allah could benefit or cause any harm. It's all from Allah the Almighty. So this is one meaning concerning فَلَا أُقُسِمُ بِمَوَاقِعِ النُّجُومِ, which means I do swear to the setting sights of the stars, which you see happening on every night and setting by the approach of the dawn every morning. The other meaning is مَوَاقِعِ النُّجُومِ. In Arabic, when we study Quranic science, it says, نَزَلَ الْقُرْآنُ مُنَجَّمًا عَلَى النَّبِيِّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ. The Quran was sent down and revealed to Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم gradually, not as one book or one volume. It was not handed to him at once, like earlier revelations. No! We read in the Quran that that Allah the Almighty gave an appointment to Musa alayhi salam. Then he gave him the scripture. That was not the case with Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Quran, its revelation started during Ramadan, and it lasted 23 years later. So it took 23 years to complete the revelation of the Quran. That is the meaning of munajjaman, gradually, part by part, ayat by ayat, sometimes a chapter by chapter. It was not revealed as one. And that's why in Surah Al-Furqan, ayah number 32, the disbelievers said, وَقَالَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا. The disbelievers objected to the revelation of the Qur'an as gradual, said, لَوْلَا نُزِّلَ عَلَيْهِ الْقُرْآنُ جُمْلَةً وَاحِدَةً. Had it not been the Qur'an revealed unto him as one shot, one volume, one book, so that we know the beginning and the end, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala explained why the Qur'an is different. كذلك, thus, لِنُثَبِّتَ بِهِ فُؤَادَكَ وَرَتَّلْنَاهُ تَرْتِيلًا. Thus, to keep your heart firm with it. And we sent it down gradually in a very organized way and to be recited in a perfect recitation. So sending down the Qur'an munajjaman was for a very effective cause and a divine wisdom, which is to keep the heart of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and as well his followers firm. It's like whenever there is an incident that needed a wahy to handle it, the Qur'an will be revealed. A mistake or an error that took place, such as on the Battle of Uhud, the revelation would come down to explain how to handle it, how to dispose whatever war spoils that took place or collected and they were not used to that, how to handle the case of the munafiqeen. In the early stage of the da'wah, there was no hypocrisy. 13 years in Mecca, only two parties, believers and disbelievers. But in Mecca, there was a third party emerged, al-munafiqeen. So to discuss this from the beginning, Aisha radiallahu anha said, what was revealed in the Quran first? Ayatun. Some verses from al-mufassal of the short surahs from Qaf and down. And had it not been, or if the first revelations included, do not drink, people would have said, we would never quit drinking. If the first revelation included do not commit adultery, people would have said, we would never stop committing adultery because it was in their blood. Somebody was a girlfriend, somebody was living a lustful life, somebody who is an alcoholic, said, no, I'm not willing to quit that. So accordingly, they would not accept Islam. But it started by establishing the belief. So there is a meaning of لِنُثَبِّتَ بِهِ فُؤَادَكَ, to keep your heart firm with it. When the companions would come to the Prophet ﷺ and complain how much suffering and persecution they're facing, the Qur'an would come down to Prophet Muhammad ﷺ to keep his heart firm and say, أَصْبَرْ كَمَا صَبَرَ أُولُو الْعَزْمِ مِنَ الرُّسُلِ. Be patient, as the prophets of the steadfastness and patience before you showed and endured patiently. We ran out of time, but this subject is a very interesting one. So far, we just spoke about the oath. We did not even touch base or scratch the surface of the subject of the oath, which is most interesting. But inshallah, to be continued, we've got to take a short break right now, and we'll be back inshallah in a few minutes. Please stay tuned.
Recite it every day and do read it loud.
Let's start from where they started. Who are they? The companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. When they started learning the religion of Islam, they started with the aqidah, the belief system, faith. Brothers and sisters in Islam, dear viewers, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam spent 13 years in Mecca teaching that generation the belief system, the aqidah. Aisha radiallahu anha confirms this by saying, the first things which were revealed from the Quran was matters of aqidah. Who is Allah? Jannah, paradise and hell. Jundub ibn Abdullah al-Bajali, may Allah be pleased with him, said, we learned the belief system, we learned the iman, we learned the aqidah. Then we learn the Qur'an. Then we learn the Qur'an. Brothers and sisters in Islam, nowadays, a lot of our cultural practices, a lot of our societal norms are against our belief system. And the reason why we're falling into this, because we did not start from where they started. Join me, Kareem Abu Zaid, twice a week on Huda TV screen with the new edition, Aqeedah Matters. See you.
The words of Allah, the Quran, sent to us by the Almighty, so we can hear and obey.
We cannot live our life without the Holy Quran. You must listen carefully to the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because your safety and my safety will be with this great verses of the Holy Quran. We are here in this world for a test, and this test, and you will have questions in the Day of Judgment.
Hear and obey with Sheikh Rifat Muhammad in Ramadan, only on Huda TV.
Recite it every day and do read it loud.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, and welcome back. In this segment, we get to recite together, and we receive phone calls for those who would like to recite this ayat and correct the recitation. In order to do that, I would like to provide and remind you with the phone numbers, beginning with area code 002-0125-00-8679. alternatively area code 002-0100-24-64-583. Barakallah fikum. I think we already have a caller, Brother Muhammad. Assalamu alaikum, Muhammad, and welcome to Correct Recitation.
Alaikum salam, how are you, Sheikh?
I'm fine, alhamdulillah, thank you for asking. We're reciting the beautiful ayat by the end of Surah Al-Waqi'aah from 75 through the end.
Yes, can I start the recitation?
Please, فَلَا أُقْسِمُ بِمَوَاقِعِ النُّجُومِ
فَلَا أُقْسِمُ بِمَوَاقِعِ النُّجُومِ وَإِنَّهُ لَقَسَمٌ لَوْ تَعْلَمُونَ عَظِيمٌ إنه لقرآن كريم في كتاب مكنون لا يمسه إلا المطهرون تنزيل من رب العالمين أفبهذا الحديث أنتم مدهنون وتجعلون رزقكم أنكم تكذبون فلولا إذا بلغت الحلقوم وأنتم حينئذ تنظرون ونحن أقرب إليه منكم ولكن لا تبصرون فلولا إن كنتم غير مدينين ترجعونها إن كنتم صادقين فأما إن كان من المقربين فروح وريحان
yes? Continue, please.
فروح وريحان وجنة نعيم وأما إن كان أصحاب اليمين فسلام لك من أصحاب اليمين وأما إن كان من المكذبين الضالين فنزل من حميم وتصلية جحيم إن هذا لهو حق اليقين فسبح باسم ربك العظيم.
سبحان الله. Thank you, Brother Muhammad. جزاك الله خيرا. Rayyan from the KSA. السلام عليكم Rayyan.
وعليكم السلام.
How are you?
Alhamdulillah.
Great. Okay, you know we're reciting from ayah number 75 through the end of Surah Al-Waqi'ah, right?
Yes.
Okay, go ahead. You may proceed.
A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. Fala uqsimu bimawaqi'in nujum. وإنه لقسم لو تعلمون عظيم إنه لقرآن كريم في كتاب مكنون لا يمسه إلا المطهرون تنزيل من رب العالمين أفبهذا الحديث أنتم مدهنون وتجعلون رزقكم أنكم تكذبون فلولا إذا بلغت الحلقوم وأنتم حينئذ تنظرون ونحن أقرب إليه منكم ولكن لا تبصرون.
Rayyan, do me a favor and read ayah number 84 again, which is وَأَنْتُمْ حِينَ إِذٍ تَنْغُرُونَ. The ta is thin, and the noon is thin, but the gunna, because of the following letter, which is dha, is thick, is fat. So you will say وَأَنْتُمْ حِينَ إِذٍ تَنْغُرُونَ. Not to convert the va into zai, okay?
Okay. Hmm. فلولا إن كنتم غير مدينين ترجعونها إن كنتم الصادقين فأما إن كان من المقربين فروح وريحان وجنة نعيم وأما إن كان من أصحاب اليمين فسلام لك من أصحاب اليمين وأما إن كان من المقربين الضالين
ريان ضالين it must be مكذبين so you just confuse the word مكذبين and المقربين rather it is وأما إن كان من المكذبين الضالين
وأما إن كان من المكذبين الضالين فنزل من حميم وتصلية جحيم إن هذا لهو حق اليقين فسبح باسم ربك العظيم
حسبك بارك الله فيك يا ريان جزاك الله خير Okay, we'll take from the studio Izzat, inshallah, from Ayah 75, please.
A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. Fala uqsimu bimawaqi'in nujum. Wa innahu laqasamun law ta'lamuna 'azim. إنه لقرآن كريم في كتاب مكنون لا يمسه إلا المطهرون تنزيل من رب العالمين أفبهذا الحديث أنتم وتجعلون رزقكم أنكم تكذبون فلولا إذا بلغت الحلقوم وأنتم حينئذ تنظرون ونحن أقرب إليه من ولكن لا تبصرون
حسبك to be continued إن شاء الله after this call we have sister Dina السلام عليكم السلام عليكم
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله
وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته from Ayah 75 of Surah Al-Waqi'aah through the end please
75 okay
yep.
فلا أقسم بمواقع النجوم وإنه لقسم لقسم لو تعلمون عظيم إنه لقرآن كريم في كتاب مكنون لا يمسه إلا المطهرون تنزيل من رب العالمين أفبهذا الحديث أنتم مدهنون وتجعلون رزقكم أنكم تكذبون فلولا إذا بلغت الحلقوم وأنتم حينئذ تنظرون ونحن أقرب إليه منكم ولكن لا تبصرون فلولا غير مدينين ترجونها إن كنتم صادقين
ترجعونها ترجعونها
ترجعونها إن كنتم صادقين فأما إن كان من المقربين فروح وريحان وجنة نعيم وأما إن كان من أصحاب اليمين فسلام لك من أصحاب اليمين وأما إن كان من المكذبين فنزل من حميم وتصلية جحيم إن هذا لهو الحق اليقين
لهو حق اليقين
إن هذا لهو حق اليقين فسبح باسم ربك
Thank you, sister. Barakallah fiki. Simra from the KSA. Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam.
How are you, sister?
I'm fine, thank you.
Great.
From 75, right?
75, yes, that's right.
A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. Fala أقسم بمواقع النجوم وإنه لقسم لو تعلمون عظيم إنه لقرآن كريم في كتاب مكنون لا يمسه إلا المتطهرون
لا يمسه إلا المطهرون
لا يمسه إلا المطهرون تنزيل من رب العالمين أفبهذا الحديث أنتم مدهنون وتجعلون رزقكم أنكم تكذبون فلولا إذا بلغت الحلقوم وأنتم حينئذ تنظرون ونحن أقرب إليه منكم ولكن لا تبصرون فلولا إن كنتم غير مدينين ترجعونها إن كنتم صادقين فأما إن كان من المقربين فروح وريحان وجنة نعيم وأما إن كان من أصحاب اليمين فسلام لك من أصحاب اليمين وأما إن كان من المكذبين فنزل من حميم وتصلية جحيم إن هذا لهو حق اليقين فسبح باسم ربك العظيم
حسبك سيستر سمرة Thank you so much. Last call we have from Samih from United Arab Emirates. Assalamu alaikum.
Assalamu alaikum wa barakatuh. How are you, Sheikh?
I'm fine, alhamdulillah. Thank you for asking. We're reciting the last section of Surat Al-Waqi'aah from ayah number 75.
You will start from the beginning of Surat Al-Waqi'aah?
No, ayah 75, the end of Surat Al-Waqi'aah. فَلَا أُقْسِمُ بِمَوَاقِعِ النُّجُومِ
Okay. Okay. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. فلا أقسم بمواقع النجوم وإنه لقسم لو تعلمون عظيم. إنه لقرآن كريم في كتاب مكنون لا يمسه إلا المطهرون تنزيل من رب العالمين. أفبهذا الحديث أنتم مدهنون وتجعلون رزقكم أنكم تكذبون. فلولا إذا بلغت الحلقوم وأنتم حينئذ تنظرون ونحن أقرب إليه منكم ولكن لا تبصرون. فلولا إن كنتم غير مدينين ترجعونها إن كنتم صادقين. فأما إن كان من المقربين فروح وريحان وجنة نعيم. وأما أصحاب اليمين فسلام لك من أصحاب اليمين. وأما إن كان من المكذبين الضالين فنزل من حميم وتصلية جحيم. إن لهو حق اليقين. فسبح باسم ربك العظيم.
سبحانه
الله العظيم.
This is what I thought you were Egyptian. Barakallah fik, brother Samih. And thank you all so much. May Allah bless you all. And as usual, we invoke Allah to make us from the people of the Qur'an. اللهم اجعلنا من أهل القرآن الذين هم أهلك وخاصتك. By that we come to the end of this edition of your program, Correct Your Recitation. Until next week, inshallah, I leave you in the care of Allah. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Brothers and sisters, to increase your iman, read the miracle, recite the Quran. Recite it every day and do read it loud. The verses of Quran are all Muslims' pride. This miracle was revealed over a long time span, sent from Allah to an angel then to a man. That man was Muhammad, the best of creation, and we were chosen to be part of his nation. He gave us a message and that was Islam. So read this miracle, recite the Quran.